against the cage. The Finnish flag carrier of relentless grappling pressure and first-round stoppage victories, Olli the amazing Santalahti, is an extraordinary mixed martial artist. He paints the canvas with beautiful strokes of unstoppable double-leg takedowns with perfect timing, precision and technique.
Ottelijana olen lopetushakuinen, monipuolinen ja vahva ottelija.
The UFC veteran from Serbia, Stefan Sekulic, is an explosion of forward-marching energy no matter where the fight goes. On the feet, he is unorthodox and hard to predict with flying knees and spinning elbows that land with merciless force. On the ground, his opponents have nowhere to escape as he rains down heavy leather or locks in fight-ending chokes.
Kao borca sebe doživljam da sam svestran. Mislim da mogu da pružim dobru borbu u stand-upu I urevanju, pogotovo u parteru. Mislim da sam čvrst I mogu da nabijem solidan tempo da publici izgleda zanimljivo.
Hän on kokenut, sitkeä ja ennen kaikkea hyvä vastustaja mulle tähän seuraavaan matsiin.
Mislim da je čvrst, snagator, može da primi dosta štete, ali mislim da sam u tehničkom aspektu bolji u svemu od njega. Pa u manje više mislim da sam u svim aspektima bolji od njega. Najviše u stand-upu, ali mislim da mogu isto da pružim dobru borbu I urvanju I da ga završi čak u parteru.
Mä uskon olevani parempi kuin mun vastustaa joka ikisellä vapaa-ottelun osa-alueella. Tämä ottelu tulee päättymään ensimmäisen erän loppupuoliskolla, kun ollaan hetki siinä mittailtu ja katsottu, mitä kumpainenkin tekee. Ja sit mä tuun ottamaan mikä on mun, eli lopetusvoitan.
Mislim da je velika šansa da ga prekinem. Verovatno u drugoj, možda u trećoj rundi. Tako da eto, to će se potruditi da bude. Eto, finish.
Mä rakastan eniten ottelemisessa voittamista, itseni ylittämistä. Jatkuvaa palkintoa siitä, minkä mä saan, kun mä tiedän, mitä mä suoriudun siellä äkissä.
Pa volim tu vrstu nadmetanja, sviđa mi se adrenalin, tako da to je nešto što me privuklo I držalo me ono najduže, to je dalje me drži od svih sportova.
Will Olli Santalahti, the master of fine arts of ground fighting, manage to make it look easy once again? Or will he be taken down and under by the gigantic Serbian tidal wave? Ladies and gentlemen, we give you the main event. Olli the amazing Santalahti versus Stefan Sekulic.
To the blue corner, Stefan Sekulic!
Watch me! Watch me! I got it!
Stefan Sekulic, the two-fight UFC veteran, fighting out of Novi Sad, Serbia, and the B-side for this, our main event of the evening here at Cage 57. Stefan Sekulic is a very, very dangerous man when he's on top, and he has a solid double leg to help him get there. But let's not make any mistakes about this. He is very well-rounded. He has excellent striking, and he's capable of using some incredible unorthodox striking when needed. Yeah, definitely. He has spinning back fists, spinning back kicks in his arsenal. But definitely still, the best part of his game is his double leg takedown and his guillotine choke. Those are the things he looks constantly. And if you give out your neck, there's a very high chance that the Serbian security will finish you. And that's a very dangerous thing for Olli Santalahti because of the fact that he himself is also a grappler. And so getting that, you know, double leg takedown puts you in danger of that guillotine choke. Yeah, this is a very interesting matchup overall, in my opinion. And I think that the one that can dictate their, or rather impose their own strong points, will likely take the fight. Yeah, you know, I'm going to venture to guess that this will be contested actually on the feet. That's my guess here, because I think Olli Santalahti is smart enough to know that the danger is there for that guillotine choke.
To the red corner, Olli Santalahti!
Stefan Sekulic is defensively very, very sound on the feet, and when he needs to, he can throw those unorthodox strikes. This is a very exciting matchup for me. He's a classic hard-nosed Finnish wrestler, as mentioned, loves that double leg takedown, and he is facing a stern test tonight in Stefan Sekulic. Santalahti is a very powerful athlete, and the double leg takedown may not be the fastest, but the drive and the pressure he brings with that, especially if he pushes you to the cage, he will finish the takedown.
Yeah.
And he has a surprisingly, or not surprisingly, but he has a very wide arsenal of submissions. Like, don't count out the underrated submission attacks of Santalahti. He's not just a wrestler, he's an excellent grappler.
Right.
He has foot locks, chokes, arm locks, he can bring it all, and he is tough as nails. He can take damage, he can dish it out, and he can go all blood and guts for 3 5-minute rounds.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, and he's, when we talk about the record and the, you could call it the history of Stefan Sekulic, you know, being a UFC veteran, all of those things, this is not Olli Santalahti's first UFC veteran. This is his second former UFC fighter he's taking on now. And as you said, he does have, you know, that penchant for finishes no matter where the fight goes. He's got 4 KOs or TKOs to his credit. He's got 5 submissions, as varied as it gets. Everything from a rear naked choke, arm bar, sumo and stretch. You know, like, he can do it all when it comes to grappling. This is a very exciting matchup here. And of course, worth noting that Olli Santalahti is coached by the legendary Kipi Hirvikangas, being one of those Finn Fighters gyms fighters. He will have a reach advantage over Stefan Sekulic. Their height will be an advantage for Stefan Sekulic, oddly enough. That's not one you usually see. But this is a very, very interesting matchup, and I'm looking forward to seeing what happens here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the night. This fight is brought to you by Presis, film, photo and advertising. In the blue corner, fighter with a professional record of 14 wins and 7 losses, weighing 80 kilos, fighting out of Serbia, Stefan Sekulic!
Watch me!
In the red corner, A fighter with a professional record of 13 wins and only 5 losses, weighing 79.9 kilos, representing Finn Federation, fighting out of Turku, Finland, Olli, the amazing Santalahti!
Here you have it. Olli Santalahti versus Stefan Sekulic, excuse me. This is an exciting matchup for our main events, and both fighters look absolutely intense. No touch of gloves to begin this first round here. Stefan Sekulic takes the center. Olli Santalahti opens up with that low kick to that lead leg.
One thing that's actually interesting is we do consider, or at least I consider, Sekulic to be the more diverse striker and maybe more experienced striker when it comes to mixed martial arts. But as you said, you think this is going to turn to a stand-up fight. Olli told me a few days ago that he has worked a lot on his striking since his last fight. So I'm very interested to see if that is actually a big part of his game plan.
You know, I have seen that through the progression of his career, that he has been working hard on his stand-up fighting. And, like, it's very clear to me, he's not just a wrestler. He has added very, very dangerous low kicks to his arsenal. And that was in full display during his last outing at Brave versus Kamal Magomedov. Oh, that was a dangerous oblique kick. Santalahti's striking has improved a great deal. But, you know, he does have a few defensive holes that I think he can close up. He has a tendency to throw these, like, single naked shots without, you know, setting it up with feints or potentially setting it up with a blitz or a flurry. Sekulic goes for that takedown, and he gets it. Santalahti, though, no, does not have too much of the neck.
And even though we talked about the both athletes striking, and they are dangerous when it comes to that, this is still their speciality. They are
right.
They are both excellent grapplers, good takedown artists, and good takedown by Sekulic. Very solid, got the legs wrapped, but Santalahti shows that power that he has just standing up.
He's doing something odd with his foot there for a second. I wonder if it was maybe having a bit of trouble. Perhaps I'm looking too deep into it. But yeah, absolutely. Both guys have an incredible grappling acumen. And I think that, you know, oddly enough, you haven't seen too much of it, but Stefan Sekulic, he's actually very dangerous off of his back as well. So if this fight does go, you know, to the ground, if Santalahti decides to get one of those takedowns he's so well known for, that's not, you know, a safe place to be. He threatened Dwayne Grant with submissions, almost finished him, like he did four others, you know, with a guillotine. So this is interesting.
Now Santalahti lets go of the head. Sekulic has him pressured against the cage, but they're both staying very calm here. I think just measuring each other out a bit.
Mm. Yeah, and I mean, Santalahti, he's good in scrambles and he has that solid defensive wrestling. So let's see if Sekulic is not able to get him to the ground and this fight happens, you know, perhaps in the open. This will be an even more interesting matchup to me to see just how much has Santalahti's striking improved, because we know that Sekulic, you know, he contested multiple fights on the feet, you know, specifically at UFC level of competition. So that's an interesting one for me. And, you know, I keep mentioning the level of competition that Sekulic has faced. Santalahti has as well, right? He's fought both at Brave and here at Cage. So against some high level of competition. That's not to be forgotten either.
Great hips and balance by Santalahti in that clinch situation. Even though Sekulic was having a bit better in the hand fight, he was getting the underhooks, getting his hands locked in. Santalahti still stood up very strong, and Sekulic couldn't finish the takedown.
Another thing to note about Olli Santalahti is that the only time he's ever had a fight end before, you know, it's time was, in terms of defeat, was by a doctor stoppage. So he's not been stopped by any of his opponents.
That was a heavy body kick by Sekulic.
Short time here in the first round of our main event of the evening. That ends the first stanza. And you can tell, Alexi, that Olli Santalahti is a good wrestler because his coach just came in here with his shirt tucked into his sweatpants and his sweatpants tucked into his socks. And that is the telltale sign of a great wrestling coach. Or one of them.
I agree.
How'd you score the round, Steve? It's difficult to say. You know, that kind of pressure that Sekulic had keeping Olli Santalahti up against the fence, I would say that, you know, the positional dominance there, and yeah, I'd give that one to Sekulic. But I'm not a judge, and that's a good thing, because I would not know what to do in some of these matchups. Round two set to begin here in beautiful Helsinki, the sparkling city that is the capital of the beautiful country of Finland.
That sounded really lovely.
I love this place. You know, it's just incredible. At any rate. Ooh. Interesting, you know, you don't always see people using that rear leg to low kick the lead leg of another fighter, right?
You know why?
I have a feeling.
Hurts like hell, yeah. If it gets checked.
Yeah.
But there are some athletes on the highest level that use that mercilessly. And if you can just kick it through, it will hurt.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, I'm not sure if it's just Sekulic being tentative on that lead leg, you know, just to stay light on his feet. He typically is. So, like, or is it perhaps a little bit of damage accumulation? Hard to say.
I would not say that his movement is too compromised in any sense yet. Olli has landed some of those shin to shin or shin to inside calf kicks, but and probably they are hurting and doing some damage, but not enough to change Sekulic's movement pattern or anything. He's still very light on his feet, faking a lot. And doing a nice entry to push Santalahti to the cage.
Shoots in for that, for the hips. And Santalahti gives him a quick little elbow to keep him honest. Sekulic is able to pull him over, however. Santalahti immediately looking, hey, maybe there's a submission here for me. Nothing doing.
Great takedown by Sekulic. Because Santalahti already proved he's really hard to take down from the body lock, really hard to pull off the cage with the double leg. So he did a nice right leg step in and just torque and twist from the hips and the upper body to get the takedown. And also they landed in the middle of the cage, which kind of makes it like more of a traditional grappling exchange. You could see in the first round when Sekulic took Santalahti down against the cage, Olli popped right back up.
Right.
With relative ease.
Yep. But not so much here in this near the center.
Sekulic is looking to posture up, maybe land some heavier strikes or advanced position to quarter mount or mount. with Santalahti's holding on with the double underhooks.
Oh, not enough action for the ref, yeah.
I'm kind of surprised Sekulic didn't push more of the pace when he had the top position, but that might be out of respect to the submission game of Santalahti.
Yeah, and I mean, he's got those credentials. You know, he's got those five submission victories. So that is something to be on the lookout for. Double leg attempt. Sorry about that.
No, go ahead. Good defense by Sekulic, and now he pushes Santalahti back to the cage.
Santalahti needs to find an answer for this kind of pressure, though. You can't just sit there, because that's time ticking away. And you got to imagine not looking so hot to the judges.
And one small thing here that is making a big thing affecting this fight is Sekulic has so far won, except now when I start talking about it, has won all the hand fighting close to the cage. So he's dominating the positioning here all of the time, like you see here. He's able to dig double underhooks, which makes it so if he doesn't want to push for the takedown, he can just control Olli. And Olli cannot force the escape. So he's stuck here against the cage, just waiting until Sekulic pushes for the takedown so he can defend and escape.
Yep. He's able to swim those underhooks in, put that head position right up against the chest or chin, and then slowly work his way, get those arms locked around the hips.
And now Sekulic has the hands locked, trying to pull all his legs together, but really, really good. Heavy hips, good positioning by Olli Santalahti.
Swims that underhook and is able to exit out. Let's see if he's able to push the advantage while he has it, at least positionally.
Sekulic was shaking his arms a little bit, getting off that clinch. So might be that he spent a lot of energy out of his arms, which does affect the punching power, at least for a moment.
Santalahti looking, both fighters, you know, at that pace, they're both looking a little winded here. That's a tough, kind of grueling pace to fight at, but it makes a lot of sense. You know, hey, that's tiring work.
In my cards, Sekulic is just a step ahead of Santalahti.
I believe so as well. In all these exchanges,
he's landing a bit better. He's not landing like super clean or super heavy. He's getting more cage control time. And in my opinion, it's the small battles. It's Santalahti is trying to strike and exchange with him. He did try one double leg in that round, which failed.
Yeah.
But it's the small battles. Sekulic is controlling the distance a bit better, landing a bit faster, a bit cleaner, faking a bit more. He's winning the hand fight against the cage, which is kind of nullifying Santalahti's game a little bit.
Right. Those minor victories in positional control lead to takedowns, lead to, you know, that pressure that keeps him locked to the cage, basically slowly attrits Santalahti, and you end up winning that decision. I have it now, for what it's worth, very little, but I have it now two rounds ahead for Stefan Sekulic. So it might not feel like it for Santalahti at the moment, but I think he needs a finish in order to win this fight. Oh, and if you're throwing kicks with that much steam, maybe he does feel the same way. Santalahti in on a takedown. Is able to get Sekulic to the mat. Let's see if he's able to keep him here or do anything of significance.
That's what I like. That's what I like. Like I said, before the fight, I think the one that can impose their own game, their own strong suit on the other one, will win this fight. Mm. Like you saw, Sekulic had a hard time controlling Santalahti. He was able to take him down a couple of times, but now we have Santalahti on top.
And you know, Santalahti, he was sitting there half guard for a second. One thing I've noticed about him is he's able to transition very well between that top half guard position and back control with the hook in. Very good at that. And that can often be, you know, one step in the chain of setting up a rear naked choke. Ducks under a big swing from Sekulic and back to the center. I hope to see a bit more urgency or pace from Santalahti here. Oh, I love that takedown myself. that leg trip.
Great takedown by Santalahti. That just shows you the drive and power. Once he gets his hands locked, you're going in for a ride. Now Santalahti, of course, has positional control. But what is he able to do with it in this short time? He should try to get his base just a little bit higher to exactly to avoid this, to get his pressure straight on top of Sekulic and look for the back take. But Sekulic swims that arm under and is able to move his way out, get his own hands not quite locked, but at least in on the hips of Santalahti. Now his hands are locked. If he's able to pull those hips out from underneath him, he'll have Santalahti on his back once again. But Santalahti,
great defense
for a head.
Yeah, great counter with a simple grip. And now Olli is again pressuring to the cage. I would like to see Olli just go.
Yeah, Olli's gonna need to
break the distance, shoot for the double again, take Sekulic down, and start working.
Or create the distance needed to actually land some significant strikes.
I still think Olli should push for the takedown, because I think his best chance for a finish is to catch Sekulic in a submission. But these prolonged cage fights or positional fights against the cage have favored Sekulic so far.
Santalahti still game here towards the end of this third round. Sekulic with a very good leg kick there. Santalahti goes high. Oh, it's a
good straight left hand from Sekulic.
This has been a grueling pace for both men. Oh, good left hand for Olli Santalahti. Sekulic fires back.
1 minute.
Santalahti pressuring forward now. Let's see what he's able to accomplish here in short time. He's throwing. Looks like a cut opened up on the forehead of Stefan Sekulic. And a cut on the bridge of the nose for Santalahti.
Santalahti is pressuring, trying to make something happen with 30 seconds to go.
Exciting tempo here in the third. Feels like anything can happen in these last few seconds. Finishes the fight with a kick to the body. A good show of respect from both men. This one will go to the judges' scorecards. Let's see what they think. You know, I would have loved to see that one go a full five-minute round. That would be quite a sight to behold.
That is true.
Here we have in the replay a big takedown for Olli Santalahti. Gives him top control, as well as a beautiful knee to the head of Stefan Sekulic. Another dump. Another knee to the head of Sekulic. Good straight left hand from Stefan Sekulic landed on Olli Santalahti there.
It looks like a clash of heads there, actually, a little bit.
That made the cut?
Yeah, yeah. I don't know, actually, that Stefan Sekulic has a cut of his own. I think what actually happened was he got blood from the nose of Olli Santalahti on his forehead. Yeah. But, I mean, I can't see that closely, even with these glasses. Corner of Santalahti, trying to stop the bleeding there on the bridge of the nose for the reading of the judge's scorecard. Excellent fight from two extremely tough gentlemen. Good back and forth grappling exchanges. A lot of heavy leather being swung on the feet. Very exciting main event.
And very high level. And very high level. You could see, especially in the clinch situations, the ground fighting. Both are very experienced, very high level athletes,
and still young.
Still young. Yeah. Yeah. Especially considering the experience that for Santalahti.
Yep. Very exciting fight. We now go to the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three full rounds, we have the judges' decision. Judge one scored this fight 28-29, Sekulic. Judge 2 scored this fight 29-28, Santalahti. And Judge 3 scored this fight 28-29, winner by split decision, Stefan Sekulic!
Stefan Sekulic takes away the victory here tonight. Olli Santalahti giving praise to his opponent. A lot to learn there. You know, he knows now, well, I'm sure he knew before, but he can hang with top-level competition. And, you know, we'll go now to the interview with Stefan Sekulic.
Stefan, congratulations. That was a great win.
Thank you. Thank you very much for the opportunity. It's really nice to fight here. I'm first time in Finland. I want to thank first the people who are cheering. I want to thank my brother Miro, who's with me. I want to thank my family at home. And of course, my coach, who couldn't be here today. And thank for organizers that called me. That's it.
Congrats. Stefan Sekulic.
Stefan Sekulic, gracious in victory and sending love back home to Serbia, to his family. Phenomenal performance from both men tonight and a very, very exciting card here at Cage 57. Stefan Sekulic, you know, his pressure in those earlier rounds really, I think, is probably what was enough to take this away, because that third and final round, that was heavily contested by Santalahti.
You are about to experience the cage.